İmam Hasekat. Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, welcome everyone to the second lecture of the series. Salman Akbulut is going to talk about shaking nuts or exotic or shake slice.
Okay, thank you very much. I will continue with Eylem's talk where she stopped. I will continue from there. But I think I should give a little bit of historical background to tie the loose ends of this talk. I hope it won't go on long with endless slides. I hope to be able to relay the ideas of this proof, what we are trying. So this is a work with Eylem Sylvia Yıldız. And let me, this subject is very dear to me, that we are talking. And this is the first paper I ever written in my career, is this paper. So I will start from the paper I wrote almost as a graduate student before my thesis about this subject. So now I would like to take you back to 1973, 74, almost 46, 47 years ago, grad students. And we don't have any tools in our hands to show smooth manifolds exotic. Only, the idea we have is, you take a four ball, attach a two handle, take another four ball, attach a two handle, whether you can get these two things to be exotic copies of each other. That was the hope, the naive hope at the time. So, you hope that, first of all, can you find such an example? And can you get in such examples, one four ball with a handle attached to slice knot, it's a slice knot in here. The other one is a four ball with two handle attached non-slice knot. Can you find an example like this? I should tell you before this, Kirby and Licorice found examples of three manifolds, same three manifolds obtained by doing surgery two different knots before this. So this, first of all, I want to do four manifold version of it. Can I find four ball with a handle, with a different two handles, handles attached to different knots. So suppose I found such an example.
You want framings to be the same, right?
Yeah, it has to be the same. I mean, I want them to be diffeomorphic manifolds, algebraic topology. So this is a B4 with a two handle. This is another B4 with a two handle, attached with the same framings, of course. So suppose I got such an example, what would I get? First naive hope is, well, there's a two sphere in here. There should be two sphere in here. But since this knot is not sliced, you get an exotic manifold, but it doesn't happen. This diffeomorphism, if you find such a diffeomorphism, you only have this sphere going through this handle algebraically once. So as Eylem pointed out, by making this copy of this embedded sphere transversal to this boundary of four ball, you get an example that four ball bounding disk with holes. So I mean here you have a bunch of D2s inside of the handle. What you have in here, disk with holes, like here, disk with holes. So what you will have left is a disk with holes, and the boundary of these holes are copies of the knot, parallel to each other, oriented differently, like this. Two N copies, one is the knot, the other is oppositely oriented, okay? At the time I was writing this paper, I never written paper before, and I thought of calling them shake slice, because if you look at the comic books, when some guy slaps the other guy, shakes it, right? This shaking. So this reminds me, this shaking in the comic books. So I call them shake slice, but I was afraid to put it in the print. So I didn't use this description in my paper. Later on, this name stuck, shake slice. So when this happens, all you have is this, if you start one is a slice knot, the other is not a slice knot, all you get is if you have a diffeomorphism from here to here, this knot in here, I call K, K will be shake slice. So you draw parallel copies, 2n parallel copies with the framing R, oppositely orient them, and then this has to bound the disk with holes in the B4. I should tell you that I was very proud of this because this is the first paper that I used carving, the notion of carving. So you take a knot, you make it bound the disk in four wall, like in this case, you carve four wall along that disk. So this is the first place I use carving, and it stuck ever since. Ever since then, I use almost every other paper carving. Carvings are like the negative handles. Like resolving some conjectures like Shalomon-Manifold standard or every four-manifold BNF, you come to a place you need to carve. So carving is a good technique to extend diffeomorphism. Okay, so to come what happened yesterday, Adam's talk. So Adam said, I'm repeating it here. If you have a slice knot, four ball with a two-handle attached to a slice knot, a four ball, another two-handle attached to non-slice knot, the image will be like this. So she reminded you a knot is slice. One way of describing sliceness is a four ball with a two-handle attached to this knot has to embed in S4. As you see that, if you take this picture, if you put this inside of a four ball, two balls in here, the handle, this handle is in here. So slice means that you look at your knot in here, inside of a S4, and this is S3. Knot is slice means there's a disk in here. So this part of the B4 and that together is a four ball with a two handle attached along K. This is notation we are using in here, K0. So you get that K0 embeds in S4. And conversely, if you have K0, this four manifold embedded in S4, not a slice. If you see this shaded part inside of S4, clearly there's an S3 in the slice disk. So this is what, this is a description of Fox-Miller, 1966. So this is a similar description I came up 1977. Almost 10 years after that. Similar thing was shake slice. If these things are diffeomorphic, as we saw you have an embedding of this object inside of a S4. This object is K0N that we just talked about. This is the B4 with a generalized two handle attached. Generalized two handle is disk with many holes thickened attached to B4. So the similar observation gives you, Fox-Miller observation gives you, and not its shake slice, if and only if K0N, this object, is generalized to handle by the embeds in S4. So she posed this question, is it possible that K0 sits inside of K0N? What would that mean? Well, if not its shake slice, then we know this. If we know that this embeds in here, then you would get K0 embeds in S4. That we will get a slice. So shake slice implies slice would be a consequence of this, if you prove this, K0, this object embeds in this. And then she proceeded to draw handle body of K0M last time. Are there any questions so far? I will go slowly and then you can ask many questions. This is what happened yesterday.
I mean, so here, like, what is N? Like, is it like for all N or?
N is, remember.
It's like the number of parallel copies, right?
Number of copies. This is how many copies do I have here? 2n plus 1 copies. One is not itself. The others, even number of copies oriented oppositely. So this is 2n plus 1. We call this n shake slice.
So when in that, like if and only if statement, when you have an n, do you mean like
n is arbitrary.
Arbitrary, okay.
Yeah. N can be any n.
Okay.
Any more questions? I mean, this is, okay, so this is the... This is the manifold before with the two handle attached along this. Oops. Let's make it smaller here. Here. So that's this manifold. And Alam draw the picture of this manifold. Okay, so now this is where she stopped, she finished her talk. So this is my manifold on the left. This is K0N. This is the handle body of it. What's the handle body of it? Well, it is, there's only one two handle. There's only one two handle in here. I draw it by itself. This is one two handle. This is K0, this thing. So this red one is K0. K0N is this picture. K0N is this picture. So K0N is obtained from K0 by carving, because all these things are, they are dots on it. They are dots on it. They are all unknots by themselves. They all, this, there are 2N circles in here. N of them, N is equal to 2 in this case. 1, 2 horizontal ones, and then 1, 2 vertical ones. They are disjoint circles. You carve them. Where do I carve? I mean, is it unique carving? Yes. If you specify this dotted circles in here, describes where you carve them. Like this, when you have a knot like this. If I put a dotted circle, so you make this move, you get two unknot circles, and then you cap them. So this is a picture of. Like a glove, so you're moving pictures, you move like this. So every time you have a knot, like this is a slice knot, then under or over is in here. Then I draw like this, that describes a four manifold. The disk, it bounds. What does that mean? Along this dotted line, you connect. You connect this. Then it becomes two disjoint circles. Then you cap them. I draw moving picture of a disc. It's not bounds. So it does. So in here there are dotted circles in here, and there are dotted circles in here. They describes how the embedding disc is. So every time you see a picture like this with the dots in here, that means carved circles, and this dotted lines in here tells you how the carving is done. Is that clear? Okay. So I would like to prove that this thing embeds. So our goal is to prove shake slice implies slice. We need to prove that. Well, one way to prove is you find an embedding K0 in the K0N. So you see, this is a picture of K0N. This is a picture of K0N. Inside of it, you see K0. This is that picture. But it doesn't have the embedded copy because of these carvings. There are circles around it. You carve those circles, and now this no longer is a picture of K0, because this carved circle destroyed it. But if I didn't carve it along these dotted lines, if I carved it, if I change, I'm a colorblind, I guess this red is supposed to blue something, or vice versa. So if I replace these two dotted ones to this dotted ones, if I change carvings of these circles, then K0 sits inside of it, because when you carve it, you connect them like this, it comes free in the moving pictures. So our goal is, one of our goals is find some kind of isotropy taking that dotted arcs to these dotted arcs. Is that clear? If I make the, if I do these connections like this, then like this, this will come free. This will come free, and then that will be outside. So one of the goals is to find such an isotropy which will do this job. Okay, so remember, I started with a big if. If you have a diffeomorphism, like if you have a diffeomorphic, if they are diffeomorphic, then I can talk about Shake's license of this knot, of this knot, if I have a diffeomorphism. Now let me tell you how we find a diffeomorphism, such a diffeomorphism. That's an example. There's a four ball with a two handle attached to this knot. The other one is a four ball, two handle attached to this knot. This knot is sliced. From this slice mode, you can check it. And this knot is not sliced. You can check computer signatures, some simple invariant of the knot, you can prove this knot slice. Now you attach a two handle with R framing in here, two handle with R framing in here. I claim these two B4s are diffeomorphic. How do I find such a thing? Well, so this is what I did in 1977 paper. You know, once I did this, I realized there's only one way of doing it. And after that, every time I want to find an example, I keep doing the same thing. In fact, recently, there are examples like this, doing the same thing, different knots, using the same four manifolds. KR and KLR are the same four manifolds. It always almost follows with these principles. The principle is this: if you have a one handle, and then you let's draw this time. If you have one handle dot, and you have two handles, one and the two handles, say framing R and R. If I cancel this two, suppose I cancel this two, then I will get one knot R. If I cancel that two, then I will get another knot R. This is basically the idea. You need to put yourself in a configuration where you have one handle, two handles, where you call this like A, B, and C, where handle A can cancel with C, handle B cancel with C. So you first cancel A with C, see what happens to this handle. Then you cancel B with C, see what happens to this handle. So this is an example. I mean, one of them will be easy if it was going once like this. Like it's an example. There's a one handle, there's a two handle going like this, another two handle going algebraically once. Canceling these two very easy. You just erase these two, you just get this picture. But canceling these two, this two handle and that one handle is a little bit hard. To do that, I need to slide that over one handle so that it will, this two handle will go through the one handle exactly once. In the process, it will smear that two handle, but it will itself will go through once. So here I do the handle slice in here over the one handle. I moved at that position. Now my handle, my knot going through once. You know how to cancel those things. If you have one handle and two handle going through once, you cancel it. Basically erase these two things and then you slide everything else over the two handle. So this, you show me any example, such an example, two different knots giving you same four manifolds, KR and LR, I will show you this configuration. So recently there are many papers and they keep repeating this configuration. This is a land post, what to look for. Okay, so this example is an interesting example because one is sliced, as I said, and this is not, the other is not sliced, exactly what I was looking for. This only works for when R different than zero. This process, unequal to zero case, we don't know. So this case, this is an example that this knot is a shake slice. This knot is a shake slice knot. Because the formula was diffeomorphic. In fact, we use it as a diffeomorphic as a definition. If you have a knot, you attach two handle along that knot to four bolt. If there's embedded sphere, we call it a shake slice. So in this case, it's an example, it's a shake slice. This is so we are able to find non-trivial knots which are shake slice, which all are. So the question is, what happens at zero? When you try simple things, it doesn't work. When you try to construct a zero shake slice knot, they look like they're a slice. So this is the main major case that we wanted to resolve. We resolved it, Aram. We proved that if you have a zero shake slice knot, it has to be slice. As you know, it's difficult to prove not a slice, but it's easier to prove four manifolds are diffeomorphic because you do handle slice and you play with four manifolds. So once you attach a handle to that knot and you play around, you get the other knot with a handle attached. Then that means knots, if one is sliced, the other has to be sliced. So this is our goal, to prove that zero shake slice knots are sliced. But we know that when our shake slice knots don't have to be sliced. This is an example. This is a non-sliced knot. This is a sliced knot. Yeah, if you want to. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay, so now you also ask that, do you know any knots that are not shake slice? And not, this is a knot, non-trivial knot, non-slice knot, but when you shake it, because they are diffeomorphic, it bonds disk with holes. Can you find an example? No matter how you shake it, it's not shake slice. So in that example, Aylam also talked about, this is one knot, this is another knot, this is slice. This is not slice. Yeah, it's written in here. This is slice. This is not slice. But there is no diffeomorphism as four manifolds. When you attach a two handle here, the two handle here, there's no diffeomorphism. So therefore, we call this, in fact, there's a homeomorphism by using Friedman's theorem and algebraic topology. They are homeomorphic. You get homeomorphic but not diffeomorphic manifold if you can find such an example. So that's also interesting. So shake slice is important. This is also important. Can you find pair of knots? One is sliced, the other not sliced. But when you attach handles to four ball along them, they are not diffeomorphic to each other. They are exotic copies of each other. Okay. This happened 1991. We had to wait for Donaldson's result. Donaldson first find first example of a closed exotic copy of a closed manifold. From there, this example was extracted. How was it extracted? Yeah, first from Donaldson's result, you find some objects called quarks, contractible smooth manifolds, and the quark is a diffeomorphic contractible manifold with a diffeomorphism on the boundary. This is the quark, which takes one loop to another loop. And this loop is sliced in one side and not sliced in another side. You attach handles to that. And then you cancel. Then you cancel this one handle, two handle, this one handle, these two things. They don't look like canceling, but by sliding this over there, we can cancel these two. So in here, I'm going to cancel these two, one handle and two handle. In here, I'm going to cancel these two. To be able to cancel, I need to first jump over that. So this shows that not all knots are shake slice. So this is in particular, they are not diffeomorphic. The way we prove they are not diffeomorphic, we prove that there is no embedded two-sphere inside of this manifold. There's no embedded two-sphere using the junction equality in gauge theory. There's no embedded S2. So not all knots are R-shaped slice. Okay, this the answer. That answer explains this. R equal to zero, this process doesn't quite work. R equal to zero case, this is an extension by Yasui. This also works. This technique also works. Same. So yeah, so I need to find the contractile manifold, this two, one and two handle. And the diffeomorphism on the boundary take this red circle to another red circle, then attaching two handles to that red circle, you obtain this two. So let me explain that a little bit more, what Donaldson did. So Donaldson 1990, so I had to wait 15 years to be able to get this example, not shake slice knots. So this is maybe good for young people who are working on a problem. So it's okay, you can wait 10, 15 years to finish your problem. So we found R-shaped slice knot, not R-shaped slice, to find a not R-shaped slice knot, you have to prove that they are exotic copies of each other. Any questions? So how does this follow from Donaldson? So now we come to 1990. He found close, smooth, four manifold and an exotic copy of this manifold. This closed manifold was a Dogdachev surface. So it's a manifold with an exotic copy. And then I just worked on the handle body of these manifolds. They look extreme, almost the same. This is also N. They decompose along the contractile manifold W in the same piece. I should write, I draw the same piece also N. It's also N. Okay. So these two are exotic copies of each other. They're homeomorphic, but not diffeomorphic. The reason they are not diffeomorphic, because it is a piece, contractile piece, and this contractile piece cut out and put it with the involution in here. Any questions? And then when I got this contractile piece, I realized this is the handle body. This is one handle and two handle. By the way, this is not the Mazur manifold. People mistakenly call this Mazur manifold because this is a Stein manifold. Mazur manifold is not Stein manifold by orientation reasons. Also, it's a similar manifold, Mazur manifold, that has a framing tree in this case. Mazur's famous paper, Annals of Mathematics, he constructed this manifold called Mazur manifold. This corresponds to this manifold with the one handle, two handle, the framing tree. But this has to have framing zero. This makes this a Stein manifold, and this does all the tricks of the cork that you need for cork. Even worse, sometimes I see in papers Mazur cork. The Mazur contracted manifold isn't a cork. It's not symmetric. There's a tree in here. Okay. So from here, you get this result. So you have a contractile manifold W, and the diffeomorphism on the boundary. This diffeomorphism takes this loop, A loop, to B loop, okay? Such that when I attach a two handle to A, I get this manifold. If I attach a two handle to B, I get this manifold. The way you see this part is very easy. I'm attaching two handle with minus one framing. You just simply cancel these two. If you know how to cancel handles, you slide all these things over that, you get this picture. To cancel this, you need to work a little bit more. You need to first slide this over that so that this black one will go through this dotted circle once, and then you cancel it. So it is in my paper. It's very easy, and then you get this one. So you get this example in here. So from here, it follows that this manifolds, two, four manifolds, cannot be diffeomorphic to each other. Because if they are diffeomorphic to each other, I can carve, see? Because this is just basically contractile made from this cork with a two handle. I take the dual linking circle of this, and that I take the linking circle of that. There's this diffeomorphism on the boundary taking A to B. So this two handle goes to that two handle, linking circle goes to linking circle. You cut them across the linking circle. You get this contractile manifold, diffeomorphism on this contractile manifold, extending the involution of the boundary. But I started with the example which doesn't extend. I have this involution which takes this circle, this circle. This involution doesn't extend inside. I attach handles. If this manifold were diffeomorphic, this manifold were diffeomorphic, I can carve across these circles and get rid of the handles. I will get a contradiction. So this is how you prove that these manifolds with handles attached, two handles attached in here, they are exotic copies of each other. In fact, this has a sphere inside, and this has no sphere inside. We can prove this by adjunction equality. But this was a, there was no Cyber-Witten at the time. I had to use Donaldson, and they're not Dogleschev surface, but the blown-up Dogleschev surface. So we know examples of R-shaped slice for all R different than zero. We don't know what happens zero if we know examples of zero-shaped, non-trivial zero-shaped slice. And we, now also we know that we know examples of not R-shaped slice, not for all R, not zero, trivial. I mean, you can also extend this for any framing. Okay, for the case zero case, this technique also gives you a zero framing case. Yes, we wrote a paper about that. Any questions so far? So we have examples of pair of knots. One is non-trivial knot, non-slice knot. The other is R-shaped slice, and we have pair of knots. Not R-shaped slice. One is sliced R, it's not R-shaped slice. For each R, different than zero. So this is a really important open case. Neither zero shaped slice nor R slice. Because all other cases are covered here. I know non-slice knots with R-shaped slice for each R different than zero. I also know not R-shaped slice knot for each R. From this exotic copies of from this exotic manifolds, which are not diffeomorphic, because if to say that this is shake slice, you need an embedded sphere in here. So it's almost proved that, because if the slice, there's an embedded sphere inside of that. If they were diffeomorphic, it will throw an embedded sphere in here. Any questions? So this is a technique you from corks. So this is a cork. This is sometimes called cork to get manifolds like this, exotic manifolds like this. So by namely attaching handle A, I need to find pair of circles which cork automorphism take this pair of circles, and I attach handle to A, handle to B. In this case, minus one framing. So these are the way to generate exotic manifolds. This is a very nice example because it's extremely very simple. You can put this one in the right pocket and this one in the left pocket. Yeah, I have exotic copies in my pockets. Yeah, just take it and look at it. I mean, later on with Danny Rubin, we proved corks themselves. These corks themselves can be made. Exotic copies can be produced from the cork. But that manifold has a lot of handles, ones and twos. They are not as simple like this. These are two, four, only two, one, two, two handles. So with Rubinman, we were able to prove, find exotic copies of this contractile manifold. This we call it absolutely exotic. Now there's another thing you can do. Finding a pair of circles, like this automorphism, this taking this circle, another circle, which one of them is bounds in here. Let's see, you can see that bounds in here. The other doesn't bound. Generate these examples. You can also find, do other things to this cork. You can find another pair of circles. I will call them capital A, capital B, capital A, capital B, where this A is slice and B is slice. What good does it do? Well, I do my famous process. I can carve this. I have a diffeomorphism on the boundary. I have A going to B. These are new pair of circles. A is slice, B is also slice, and I carve these two manifolds. What remained is diffeomorphism from the what remained manifold, but that diffeomorphism cannot extend inside because I know it's a cork. I will, by carving across here, I get partial extension. So these are small AB circles look like this. Small, big AB circles look like this. I need a circle, image of that circle. Both should bound the disk. They should do something for you. So that's an example. I draw contractile manifold like this. And that this pair of circles are A and B like that. In fact, they are isotopic to each other. We can take this circle, put it over there. They are isotopic circles, AB. But A doesn't, you know, A doesn't bond the disk in here because this is not a circle, but B bonds a disk. But how can that be? A, where A is isotopic to B, B bonds a disk inside, A should bond. Yes, it does. Not this disk that you're attempting to do. You take a cylinder from A to B, you can see a cylinder connecting them, then use the disk, B bonds. So A bonds a disk, kind of a funky disk, B bonds a simple disk. So when you carve across that disks, you get this is a contractile manifold. You carve across, remove this disk, tubular neighborhood of this disk. You get homotopy S1 cross B3. Because of four ball, from four ball, you remove a disk, B2 cross, thicken D2, D2 cross D2, you'll get homotopy S1 cross B3. So when you remove this A disk, you get this picture. You remove B disk, you get the same picture. Ah, how can that be? Well, this homotopy S1 cross B3, you get this slice knot, but there are two different slices. Since there's this slice move, you do this, and or you do this slice move. So when you remove tubular neighborhood of B, you carve B from this W, you get this manifold. This is a slice knot with a dot on it. Or if you carve across A, remember the disk you are using a cylinder union and disk of this, then you get the same circle with dot, except this with a different slice disk inside. So you get a slice knot in here, two different slice disks. Remember, dotted arcs like here describe what it bounds inside a four ball. It's a notation. So if you use this slice knot, when you put a dot in here, it tells you how this what kind of disk it bonds. You just do the slice move, pair of circles, cap them. You do it in here, you do the same thing in here. So this gives you some diffeomorphism on the boundary of this, which doesn't extend inside. So this pair of manifolds, homotopy equivalent to circle, S1 cross B3, one is exotic copy of the other. In fact, both of them are obtained same knot, a different carving. So if you carve, so these are the carvings you get. You can also draw this picture like this. You put one and two handle. And when you cancel this one and two handle, you put across one twist here like this. So this is a nice picture. It looks more symmetric. This is a knot inside of, this is a picture of B4. So this is also a picture of B4. Picture of B4, you can just write as an empty set. You don't have to do it, just to draw the knot. But in here, I do one and two handle. When you cancel them, you get a B4. Inside of this B4, knot looks nicer, like that. Okay, now, what does that knot look like? So this one, cancel one and two handle. Here. What does that knot look like? That knot which bonds two different slice disks. Well, you just jump over this manifold, just fly over this, and you look it from top inside. You'll see a four-leaf clover picture, just from here. Do you see it? You just fly over it, just look perpendicular down. You'll see that picture. This one hand circle with that is this one. You cut from the strings and you do it. You put it on the table, you get at the top. Okay. Now remember, these are very important. Remember I do this from cork. I do two kinds of tricks. I find pair of circles, which cork automorphism take one to the other, one slice the other, not slice. I use it to generate exotic copies of manifolds, pair of manifolds. Here I did something different. I found pairs of circles, which both are slice. But they are kind of funky places, different funky places. Then I carve across them. I get a very symmetric, interesting manifold. interesting or not, which bound two different slice disks. They are not isotopic fixing boundary by because they come from the core. So you ask yourself, is there some kind of isotopy taking A to B? Because in one slice, if you use this slice, this bonds a disk. But this circle, do you see the yellow circle here? There's a yellow circle here. So the yellow circle is not sliced if you carve it across here. If you carve it like this, then yellow circle becomes a slice. There are two different slices, this nut bonds two different slices. In one slice complement B bonds a disk, the other slice complement A bonds a disk. Remember what I'm doing? So doing this, you do a slice move like that. So if you have a circle like this, after this slice move, that becomes free. So therefore, when I do slice move across here, B becomes free and bounds a disk. If I do slice move here, across here, A becomes free, bounds a disk. So the two different slice move. Now, pretty soon, I will ask the question, is there an isotope taken A to B? That is going to be important step solving our problem with ALAN. Well, there is when you look from the top, you see a certain symmetry of this four leaf clover. The symmetry is 180 degrees rotation. You take this axis in here, you just rotate it 180 degrees. When you rotate 180 degrees, A circle goes to B circle, B goes to A. So I found some isotopy and some diffeomorphism, which induced by the rotation, which taking this circle to that circle. It's not clear from this picture. When I draw it four leaf clover, then it's very simple. There's just rotated A to B. Are there any questions? So this will play important role. Zero shake slice. Yeah. So this is, this is the manifold ALAN draw. This is the manifold. K0N. So she said this is obtained by this carved out L0N, the two handle in here. This is it, just repeating that. So I know that in this manifold in here, carved across here, if I change carvings from here to there, that K0 becomes free. Remember, I was trying to find whether there's an embedded K0 in here. It will imply that shake slice implies slice. Because shake slice means this this object, all this manifold sits inside of S4. So if I can find K0 inside of it, I will be done. I will be done if the dotted circles weren't carving, it was if they were carving like this. But in the handlebodies we draw, they really are these carvings. So we ask ourselves this question, can I somehow isotope so that this A dotted arcs go to B dotted arcs in somehow? So then carving across here will correspond carving across here, and then K will come free. Is that clear? So this is a picture. So this is a K0N. There's a carvings. Remember, this is real. There's only one single two handle. The other negative handles. Those are carved from, these are all carved from before. Carved. I told you, most of stuff I play with about with carvings. So this is the most funky carving we did with ALAN. So this is just carved negative handles, and it's only one two handle there. So can I somehow, so I know this yellow part sits inside of S4 or R4. Can I change this carvings like this? This object still sits inside of R4. It still sits inside of R4. this is sits inside of R4, S4. If I carve like this, is it still? Well, I mean, you might say that, yeah, because it's S4. You don't know it's S4. So this object, this yellow object, which is L0N, carved like this. If I change the carvings, that means I'm taking yellow object, putting another one object there by changing the carvings. I'm asking myself whether this is still S4. This is like a Gluck twist problem. This is an interesting problem to work on for people, for especially students. In S4, you take one of these carved disks and then you change their carvings, meaning that you change negative angles. You cut this out, put that in, do you still get S4? If you get an S4, then my problem is solved. And we have no idea when I change this like this. So for that, we are asking a desperate question. Can I somehow find an isotropy of this link, taking this dotted A dotted arcs to B dotted arcs, nice isotropy taking there. Okay, and then I in fact demonstrated an isotropy in here. That's this picture. There's an isotropy induced by 180 degree rotation. There's the picture of KZ, this is the picture of K01. Why doesn't that solve the problem? Well, remember, so this is the L0N to get, LN0. Oh, no, LN0 like this. So KN0 obtained by attaching two handling here. Okay, so I'm seeking an isotropy of this red. I mean, you might say, but you are cheating. There was a knot tied in here. So just imagine there's a knot tied in here, or simplest I'm drawing like that. So I know that there's an isotropy taking gamma to f of gamma from this clover leaf isotropy. So in fact, this clover leaf isotropy, I mean, this is n equal to one case like this. In the n equal to two case, this, when you look at draw from the top, you keep looking at the top, you see that this clover leaf grows, becoming bigger clover leaf. And then they're all, when you do 180 degree rotation, this alpha and f, the alphas and f of alphas go to each other. That's what I want to do, like this. So in fact, 4th of July this year, Aylan found a clover leaf on the institute garden. And then I put a tweet on the 4th of July. I said, maybe this is an omen that next paper from GGTI will have this clover leaf in it. This is exactly my tweet, 4th of July tweet. So you can see that, you know, this will help this prophecy fulfilled. So then I go back in here. So now I need I know that there's an isotropy taking gamma to f of gamma in here. But when you do this isotropy, and then you do the carvings, will extend inside. But if you change that, you will have to change the carvings in here to make it four manifold diffeomorphism. When you do the same carving, the gamma f of gamma, they just describes to you some diffeomorphism on the boundary of LN0, taking this loop to that loop. That diffeomorphism doesn't extend inside for Cork reason. Same proof we prove in our paper. This diffeomorphism that I described in here, the rotation, okay, which automorphism taking this to that, does not extend inside if you have the same carvings. But if I change carvings of this one, okay, then it extends. But they are not the same manifold. They are carved differently. Any questions? So this picture is really this picture. 180 rotation. Or from n equal to 2 case is in here. It's 180 rotation here. This picture. So A dotted A's will go to A dotted arcs will go to this dotted arcs here. Okay, so this is the problem. So I almost get, by rotating this and carving, I get this guy bounding a disk because I'm throwing it in here. But this guy bounds a disk in this kind of carving. By the way, do you know why this, if you have like a ribbon in here, in a circle, this circle bounds a disk in complement of that ribbon. And I gave this exercise in my book because you write this ribbon is like this. Canceling, so this zero dot dot, this is ribbon. It is clearly it doesn't bounce a disk in here because this there's a carving in here. But when I draw it like that, so this is ribbon. I broke ribbon in two, and then these are this one handle and two handle. Cancel, when you cancel this, you go to that picture. But by doing this, you are able to show that this not gamma in here, bounds a disk across in here. That's the reason this guy will bounce a disk in this manifold. If you take these carvings. But when I do this rotation, you also change the carvings. This carving will go to that carving. I'm screwed. Are there any questions? Okay, so now, so the expressing that I need to find an isotropy taking gamma to f of gamma in here. This is the good curves. These are the good curves. This is the bad curve taking this with an isotropy. The same picture. So this is 180. This is 180 explanation of that. Now this is the final page, our proof. So let's see what we have in here. Here, this manifold in here. Yeah, so let me just go like this. Take a four ball in here, and this with a color, okay? Boundary of four ball, you put this clover leaf, okay? And then clover leaf bounds disks by carving either way. In either across gamma or across f of gamma. So do you do one of them? You take one of them. So this is this manifold, which I called L and zero, L zero M. If you carve like this. And now in the cylinder, you extend this, there are a bunch of circles that you were carving. You extend them, carvings of cylinders. And then this red curve is just the gamma curve in here. You know, why did you do that? I just extended this cylinder in here. Well, I mean, I have an isotropy, again, I repeat. I have an isotropy taking gamma to f of gamma. This picture is really that picture, this picture or that picture with a 180 rotation of this link. So I do 180 rotation and I carve it before. So I take a top. I just imagine the clover leaf picture. You do 180, you come in bottom in here. It's that isotropy. When you do that, the gamma goes to this, the other gamma goes here, but the problem is not solved because the carvings also thrown to each other. This carving also grown different carving that still doesn't bound in here. So what you do is you take B4 with a color in here, B4 with a color in here, you glue with F1, 180. So I'm just gluing a color to B4, a strict cosine with a 180 degree rotation. Then do the then continue the carving. So this is just the standard color. This is the color glued by this rotation lamp. So when you come all the way down in there, because of this gluing in here, you won't see this carving, you'll see this carving. Great, then f of gamma will bound, f of gamma in here, will bound the disk in that carving. Because I forced it gluing, I changed this gluing.
Sorry, like in the picture in the bottom, just the bottom left.
Bottom left, yes.
You have that S3 cross the interval part, and the yes. Like that at the bottom you start with the identity bottom. At the top. Yeah, at the top you have gamma equals k. I mean, is what's in between, like the, like cobordism coming from the carving, or?
So it is B4 and S3 cross I. Then I start carving B4. Remember, these are all carvings. Mm-hmm. Carving B4 at the bottom.
Yes.
And
yeah.
Bunch of circles, and then you extend them by just trivially along the color like this.
Mm-hmm.
The carve. These are cylinder carve.
Sure.
And at top, I'm attaching a two-handle to gamma. This handle.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that makes sense.
Come like this, but it gets stuck at the bottom because it cannot bound this guy at the bottom. Cannot bound the disk because of this carving. This doesn't evidently bound the disk at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So to solve that problem, I turn this to clover leaf, and then replace this S3 cross 0, 1, the cylinders with a 180 degree rotation isotopy. In that process, this is drawn to here.
Yeah.
If you leave as is, that with that carving, I still didn't solve the problem because this is drawn in here with this carving. It will be, when I did this 180 come down, this carving will replace the change with this carving. This still doesn't bond disk underneath. Because just look at the color, S3 cross 0, 1, and then straight cylinders that carved, you carve with 180, come down. When you do that, gamma will go to F of gamma in here. Then I want to continue, downstairs is L0N. I want to continue, but I cannot. The L0N downstairs is a different L0N. Is carved across here. Then I'm not able to see that this bounds the disk anymore because it is not carved across this little ribbons. Or maybe this picture is better. When you do like the N equal to 1 case, when you do 100 degree rotation, this was a bad place, there's a good carving like this. It went 180 rotation, we throw this one to that one, but good carving now thrown out here, the bad carving become the good carving. It doesn't solve the problem. In fact, when we write this, our paper, submit journal, we forgot, we wrote this isotopy upside down. So that it appears like there's this problem that they caught right away. So we're revising that part. And then this is really this part owes to Adam's eagle eye. So I was putting this isotopy reverse. So what I do is going top to bottom, I do 180 rotation. These are straight cylinders down. And this is the bad place. This is a bad place which doesn't bound in L0N. It wasn't bound to disk. It got stuck in here. But because I put this isotopy and I carved with this isotopy of these circles with 180, and then it still won't bound the disk in here, but I glued it with 180 diffeomorphism, rotation diffeomorphism in here. So that saved us downstairs. So this originally went to here, but at the bottom, this because of that gluing, downstairs will look like carving like this. So what I did is, you go back, so before with a color, with a bunch of cylinders and a bunch of disk removed, before with a color, bunch of different disk removed, and then such that gamma now bounds disk in complement. So when you attach a handle, you see K0 in here. Our problem is solved. Are there any questions?
Like, by the way, we have like 2 minutes left.
This is very important, this thing. Okay, so any questions? Any part of this? So remember this 180 rotation concordance. You start at top, clover leaf, 180 rotate, come down. When you do this, positions of this red circle switched on the, and the position of carving switched. Bed carving went to bed carving, circle enclosing bed carving, went supposed to go to circle enclosing good carving, but still went to bed carving because carving is also switched. But then what we do is in here, at the bottom, we glue with this diffeomorphism, the rotation diffeomorphism. When you have it before with a color put in, doesn't matter how you put this color with a diffeomorphism of S3, the rotation, still before. So you do this carvings. That's all. That's the end of the proof. So I accomplished this this goal, which Einem said yesterday, this goal. I embedded K0 inside of K0N. Now, this is kind of amazing for following reason. When I start with the exotic manifolds, by carving, I get this manifolds. And I get exotic homotopy S1 cross B3. I got this configuration. Just watch this configuration. This is from good, you know, this there's A circle ones, this B circle ones. I carve them across. I got this picture. It's not bounding two different slices. I get an exotic homotopy S1 cross B3. By the way, later on with ALAM, we proved that you can make it absolutely exotic, this manifold. We also proved you can make the absolute exotic manifold, contractor manifold, we construct with Denny, we are able to make it Stein. This is another paper with Ada. So this comes from the exotic world, but you come to this picture, you see this picture, you go to clover leaf. Clover leaf is something about the shaking, proving positive shaking slice, not? So this clover leaf is a universal picture. It explains exoticness, like the exotic mesocork, exotic is coming from mesocork. It also explains the zero-shaped slice problem by just using it differently. I'm completely amazed how useful it is, this universal object. What happened? Got it. This meeting is being recorded, okay? What happened?
I guess you need to go back to the other app.
Okay, yeah, here. So this clover leaf appeared from exotic construction, that exotic pair of manifolds I described, also in the solution of this. Okay, so that's all I have to say.
Okay, let's thank our speakers.
Is there anybody that has asked questions?
Any questions from the audience?
So this is any questions?
Well, that was a very good presentation. Thank you.
Like, what are some sort of related open questions?
Related open questions is suppose you have four manifold which is an exotic copy of the, some other formula fault. It's obtained by a two handle to a nut, okay? Then you attach this two handle to nut, you have an embedded sphere inside. But still an exotic copy of another one which has an embedded sphere inside. So you are not able to say junction equality. Can you fill this gap in here? Can you find such an example? I mean, you want to, I think you can construct such examples. The sphere has a minus one self-intersection, because when you have spheres minus one self-intersection, you can blow them down, then you get towards the cork. So you want to find such, produce such examples. So a manifold with the embedded sphere inside, which is an exotic copy of another one. Can I, and the other one also has this embedded sphere inside. So minus one framing. You can say that the way I can construct this, check this, blow both of the spheres and then show that you are left with a cork. So this is covered with an exercise in my book. So this could be extended.
I see. Sorry, just to make sure I'm understanding correctly. So you have two, I mean, exotic manifolds. One of they're
so both they're obtained four, by... both of them, they are KR and LR.
Okay, yeah.
KR and LR. Suppose K is a slice, so embedded in KR you have a sphere, embedded mm-hmm. sphere. LR is also, L is also a slice, there's embedded a screw in there. Suppose you have this. First of all, can you find such an example? Because the way you prove one is an exotic copy of other, you prove there's an embedded sphere in one and there's no embedded sphere in the other one.
I see.
Suggestion is you have this sphere, the other one has a sphere in here. You blow down, you get a diffeomorphism, you induce a diffeomorphism of the cork. Because when you blow them minus once, you'll get contractible manifolds, and you construct in such a way you end up with cork, which you can decide. So the reverse, start with the corks, come to this example. So reverse construction.
I see.
So
can you relate that question something like to some more important question or just, you know, like by itself?
I mean,
is there a motivation?
I have two manifolds, two four manifolds, big, huge four manifolds. There are plenty of them. And one is not diffeomorphic to the other. So you want to go towards small manifolds inside exotic copies, not just finding a cork. But find, for instance, sphere in here, a sphere in the other one, such that in the tubular neighborhood of those spheres, in the some neighbors of these spheres, they also exotic copies of each other. So, I mean, simplest case is the Gluck construction. Suppose one manifold, we still don't know whether I can get an exotic copy by doing a Gluck construction, one four manifold, taking this to close to random and gluing like this.
Maybe to prove that you cannot get such exotic manifolds would give you that you cannot get.
We know you can get exotic manifolds by Gluck construction. For non-orientable manifolds, you can.
But orientable case. So then it would tell that you cannot get exotic copies by Gluck.
Okay, so then it doesn't have to be tubular neighborhood of the two sphere. It could be some neighborhood of the two sphere, small neighborhood of the two sphere. So this is my manifold. I have a two sphere in here. There's another manifold. There's a two sphere in here. Some self-intersection. This could be our self-intersection. It's our self-intersection. I need to find some small pieces enclosing that, which are exotic copies of each other. I mean, this is like understanding, finding exotic big manifolds, plenty. So you want to understand exotic small manifolds, or up the bigger manifold to smaller manifold, and find some kind of configuration like this. One thing is a plug. You know, you can do this by plugs. Something called is like cork and then plugs. And then find some different configuration that you can explain exoticness in the small neighborhood. Because this you are studying atomic structures of smooth manifolds, you know, the small pieces, how can they put together?
Okay, I'll go and stop recording if it's fine. What do you think?
Any other questions? Okay, let's thank our speaker again then.